Hi, my name is Surman from Agilent Technologies. In the previous video, I briefly introduced you how to evaluate an LNA. In this video, I'd like to focus more on the external biasing of the amplifier. Last time, I biased the amplifier using a voltage source and a bias resistor. This biasing method works well under a certain constant condition. However, if you want to precisely supply a constant bias current under various conditions, for example, over the full operating temperature range, this method is very impractical. The device voltage may change several millivolts per degree Celsius. Moreover, the device voltage varies slightly between units, so you have to adjust the bias voltage or bias resistor every time you change the device. So, what is the best way to bias the amplifier? The answer is very simple and straightforward. Just use a current source instead of a voltage source. So let me demonstrate how to evaluate the LNA using a current source biasing. You can use the previous voltage source and bias resistor setup. Just change the voltage source into current source. So let me set the power source. Change the power source B2961A mode from voltage to current, and then set the current value to 40 milliamps, the recommended value, and then set the output voltage limit, and then press the output button. Now the device is ready, so we can start the measurement. Press the trigger button and then start. This is the S parameter measurement result. There are many advantages of directly using a current source for biasing. First, you can easily evaluate the device characteristics under different bias current values. For example, you can sweep the bias current values and evaluate the gain or maybe the power consumption of your device. Second, you can provide a constant bias current while, for example, changing the ambient temperature and evaluate the performance of the device. Or, you can easily apply same bias conditions to many devices and evaluate the performance variation between units. Third, if you chose an RF choke that has a high impedance at the desired operating frequency, you don't need the series bias resistor. That makes the evaluation to be easier and faster. So you can see that using a current source enables and really helps you to perform many evaluations easier with high repeatability. If you like to have more information, you can visit our website currently shown below. Thank you for watching this video.